What's up, you jackwagons?
I am Speed Fury.
And today is part, I don't know what, of Fire Emblem Warriors Three Hopes. Let's just go ahead and get into it.
Which battlefield are you headed to?
I can continue with the way I usually upload these now. Battle of Magdred. I don't know how to pronounce that. Ooh.
The fog is rather thicker than I imagined, Hubert. And if I'm not mistaken...
Yes, I agree. Dark magic is assuredly the cause. We already know those who slither in the dark have had comings and goings at House Row. I doubt one of them is here. But there could be a mage present to receive their training.
Then we had best leverage our own assets.
Why is everyone whispering? Is the enemy aware of our coming?
It's entirely possible, yes. They could be directly on top of us, and we would scarcely know it. So yes, let us all stay on our toes. Prudent of you to bring it up, Ferdinand.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Why so quiet, Caspar? Normally, you'd be at the front of the line, making all kinds of racket.
What? You think I'm the kind of guy who'd get all scared and give our position away? Sorry, I'm not afraid of anything.
You're unusually quiet, Petra. Did you not get enough sleep or something? I am listening to our surroundings. Nothing has more danger than fog. One incorrect step and you will be losing your life. Can we all try to relax? I'm pretty sure we're alone out here, so let's just calm down before we wear ourselves out.
Sometimes y'all make me think we're still back at the academy.
Is that supposed to be a compliment?
Well, great. I was hoping to finish this before reinforcements arrive, but so be it. I will prioritize locating Lord Lenato. Can I leave the Imperial troops to you?
I know what to do, so let me do it already. Just mind this fog. Make sure you don't attack the wrong side.
That goes for you as well. Let us see if you can live up to your reputation.
I love how it's showing like a question mark, but it's clearly Geralt. I can tell from the color of his outfit. Okay, we gotta rescue Lenato. Let's persuade Ash. Get him on the team again. And Mounted Surge. Assign healers. Be what we'll do. It doesn't really matter what we go with, it looks like, because there's so many people, so much fog, we can't even tell what's here anyway. Let's see, who do we want to start with? Let's swap him with her. And we're also going to need Ash in the fight. Caspar. I always get those two confused because they look so similar in hair color.
Closer we get, the denser the fog. I can barely make out my own fingers. It should be a useful thing on the map. Best he possesses low numbers. The man for Thomas Taylor.
We need to find him before the kingdom dies and take him into our protection.
Okay, let's take the forts.
Lord Lenato will surely be hiding in one of these strongholds awaiting rescue.
The fog will come up.
Okay, let's real quick assign my troops to take a base each.
Leave this to me.
Here I go. No mistakes. Everyone, to me. I bet.
Right then. Let us go to work.
There is not a question of can, only a matter of will.
Okay, so I can take all these already, except for this one, for some reason. We'll just send Ferdinand after this one. I'll worry about the other ones on here.
Hey, I see a mage! Do you think he's responsible for all this fog?
This fog lets all the knots will have their own attack. One up this way. Take out Ingrid now.
You will pay in blood for invading the lands of Fargus. You can go get the vacuum.
All right, let me finish my recording first. Take these guys out. Let's go and head down to where we need to.
Excellent. All the citizens are safe.
Alright. Oh. Get out of the way, I'm trying to get to one of my guys.
One task on the to-do list. Now we just have to
Alright, that's our next target down there. I was wondering if he would show up.
How could you betray His Majesty Lenalto? How could you do this to me?
Better stop him before he gets to him.
You came here for me.
Ash is your adopted son, and family should not fight family. Let us persuade him to lay down his arms instead.
Oh, of course the mercenaries show up. Let's go take out the Ashen Demon then. Gerald. Knew it was him.
Guess I better get in there instead of letting the kid do all the work.
Jump me in, Captain. I may be a new arrival, but no one can rival my enthusiasm.
Again with the terrible puns. Get back here.
Slip away like it was nothing.
I better put a stop to these guys. Geralt's down. Now I gotta focus on that last person.
We're really pushing our luck here, all of this. You decide when we fall back.
After I go and get the get this chest up here. Don't wanna forget that. Now we can go put a stop to Eloise.
Conquest.
you're still the saddest looking fighter in camp. Why the long face?
Because we only barely got the job done. Everything else was a miserable failure. Sure, we saved Lenato and put Geralt and his mercenaries to rout, but we let the kingdom's troops get away in the process. And if that wasn't bad enough, I failed to beat the Ashen Demon.
Again.
Basically, we lost. Wrong. You were hired to do a job, and you did it. And in the process, you've received a valuable reminder about the unique danger the Ashen Demon poses.
You're right. I can't believe one fighter could turn the tide of an entire battle like that.
Precisely. They're surely going to continue standing in our way. So do try to dig a little deeper the next time you square off.
And I guess my goal hasn't changed. Thanks for the encouragement.
Perfect, I guess. Okay, somebody mastered one of their abilities, being Edelgard. Got Ash on the team.
We must make it. Understood. Randall, take your troops to Arian Road and await further instruction from Hubert.
Leave it to me, Your Majesty.
Why is everyone so worked up? What happened?
It seems the troops we stationed in the Alliance are in danger, and serious danger at that. Gloucester and the other lords betrayed them, and now they have been completely cut off.
Nope, the word betrayal suggests they were on our side in the first place. But I think we can safely assume that was never their intent. This whole time, they were simply waiting for us to move the rest of our army toward the kingdom. As soon as they saw an opportunity, they cut off routes to the Great Bridge of Murden and Garrick Monk. Now that our troops are trapped on Alliance lands, House Regan and House Gloucester have them surrounded on both sides. It's doubtless one of Claude's clever little stratagems, and it stings.
I don't understand. Everyone is aware of the troubled history between Regan and Gloucester. Why would they decide to bury the hatchet now? Unless the supposed feud is little more than a web Claude has spun for this exact moment.
Perhaps it is, but perhaps not. For all we know, he wants us to overthink the situation and make a greater mistake. We'd better stay on our toes. This all fell together too perfectly to be some kind of unhappy accident.
All I know is that our reinforcements will never make it there in time. The direct route east risks running into both Kingdom and Alliance forces. But if we attempt to skirt around them, we will all be aged and gray before we ever reach Gloucester.
Which means our only option is marching south. We'll regroup on this side of the Aramid River, retake the Great Bridge of Murden to cover our backs, and then cut through the enemy cordon. That doesn't sound a whole lot faster.
I would say no, but these are no ordinary soldiers. They are commanded by our greatest warrior, Count Leopold von Berglitz, the Minister of Military Affairs, and a man who has never lost even one battle. If anyone can rally our troops and convince them to hold, it's him.
What a brilliant trap. The Regan boys even craftier than they say.
I agree, sir. Even Count Gloucester's adept army seems to be acting with remarkable discipline. But will the reinforcements reach us in time?
The real question is, are they coming at all? Because if they're on the way, they'll make it in time. So long as I draw breath, they will make it. So count on them coming.
Yes, sir.
Soldiers of the Empire, I know fear gnaws at your hearts. And that's nothing to be ashamed of. Don't run from this fear. Embrace it. Take measure of the enemy that surrounds us. And look them square in the face. Yes, we're outmaneuvered and face a vicious fight ahead. But pray to the goddess for protection. And her fire will fill your soul and temper your resolve. Our only duty here is to stay alive. Be fearful of death. And let not a single soldier fall needlessly. Raise your voices with me now. Let me hear your courage. We will not lose.
Wow, these guys aren't backing down.
If anything, they actually seem more excited than before. How is that possible? They're completely surrounded. No one will ever reach them in time.
Yes, but Count Burgles is their commander. And I'm guessing a lot of those troops are veterans of the Dagda and Bridget War. During that conflict, the Count's troops held off wave after wave of Dagda soldiers right to the very end. Our force must look tame in comparison.
Okay, so what now? I wanted this to be clean, but we're looking at a complete bloodbath on both sides. What I want is the upper hand against the Empire, not these people's lives.
And there's honor in that, but I don't think they're going to play along.
They don't have to accept every part of it. I just thought they might be, you know, scared. Well, so be it. They may have boundless courage, but they don't have boundless food. If Count Burgles wants me to tighten the snare, that's exactly what I'll do.
The Empire achieves early success in the war thanks to House Gloucester, a noble alliance house whose vows of allegiance and safe passage were key to the quick capture of Garrick Mach. But Count Gloucester breaks his oath and turns on Burgles' troops, trapped in hostile territory with their supply routes severed. The Imperial Army's outlook appears bleak.
I fear I may have miscalculated, my son.
How can that be possible, Father? We have the enemy surrounded.
Yes, and they have yet to give a damn. Time grows short, and soon Edelgard's reinforcements will descend upon the Alliance.
Then we will hold them off at the Great Bridge.
And they will find another way. If they manage to take even one of the Aramid River's crossings, they can break through our ranks. And while that may not spell immediate defeat, it will dash any hopes of Count Burgles' surrender. Eventually, Edelgard's army will wash over the land and...
Speak plain, Father. I beg of you. What does this mean for House Gloucester?
Do not. This was a leap of faith we had to take to better our territory's fortunes. When Claude came to me with this offer, I determined the reward to be worth the risk. If the gamut fails, so be it. All it means is that our house will have to swear allegiance to the Empire.
Edelgard will never settle for such. She will demand... Oh, Father. No.
I am proud of you, my son. You have grown into a man strong and wise enough to lead our house.
Is there nothing that can be done? What of your dream to claim the Alliance leadership from House Regan?
It is your house now. You determine our path. Besides, when the dust finally settles from this war, there may not be an Alliance to lead.
So I am to submit to the Empire and carve out as big a place for our family as I can? Is that it? You would have me put an end to the Leicester Alliance?
Perhaps my praise of your wisdom was ill-advised. You get ahead of yourself, Lawrence. We bend the knee only if we lose, not before. And as you said, we may yet be able to drive back the Emperor's reinforcements and win the day. Always think two steps ahead, my son. Be clever. Survive. That is the lesson I seek to impart. I had best go prepare for my final battle as Count Gloucester. However this plays out, look for a way for our house to prosper and seize it, Lawrence. Seize it. That is how Irvin Fritz Gloucester fights, and it is how you must fight as well.
Well, we managed to slog our way to the encampment. Now we just have to finalize our plan.
Why is it so important to hold part of the Aramid Riverbank again? I mean, wouldn't it make more sense to cross over into Alliance territory before it's too late?
If we do, we risk the enemy cutting off our retreat. We are here to break their siege, not fall prey to one.
If we don't conduct this rescue carefully, we'll be worse off than we started. We must be smart, and that means establishing at least one bridgehead in addition to the Great Bridge of Murden.
Yeah, okay. That makes sense. The Minister is a general of much endurance. You'll be holding out until we arrive. He is more than a warrior and a maker of strategies. It would lack wisdom to be making an enemy of him.
Yep, that's my father. No one can beat him. I just hope I can be half the warrior he is one day.
I think even one and a half Burgleses would be more than enough. Not that it's any of my business. So, what are we to do about House Gloucester?
They have indicated a willingness to swear fealty, for whatever that pittance of a promise is worth. That leaves only Phlegethon and Ordelia. And I doubt very much that anyone would take us to task for dismantling them.
The head of House Ordelia is one of the five great lords. Dismantling them, as you say, would hamper Her Majesty's ability to rule effectively in the future. Consider, for example, why we chose not to dismantle House Eyre.
Because I belong to House Eyre, and you did not have to.
Ah, of course.
You are happy so long as they install successors who are willing to toe the line.
That is the plan, yes. House Phlegethon, however, must be disposed of. Their lord, Acheron, has leveraged his control of the Great Bridge to do whatever he well pleases. I have a suspicion the Alliance desires him gone as badly as we do.
Lawrence Gloucester and Lysithia von Ordelia were Her Majesty's schoolmates, yes? They may be more willing to listen to reason than the others. Sure, but Claude went to the Officer's Academy too, and he's taken a firm stance against the Empire. Do you really think this can be handled via diplomacy?
That will depend on precisely what their demands are. But first, we must retake the Great Bridge and extricate Count Burgles and his troops. Let us focus our energies on that for the time being.
Agreed. And it would behoove us all not to overlook how devious Claude can be just because we went to the Academy together. If he's not willing to come to the table, I won't hesitate to meet him on the battlefield instead.
I won't hold back either. Sometimes you have to kill old friends in this line of work. That's just how it is.
Instruction comes at a high price.
All right, let's treat some of my characters' tactics that they didn't have before, starting with Aelgard. Hubert.
I imagine this. I must make the most. I must make the most of this ability.
My mother is sitting directly behind me. She's probably very annoyed at the repeated talking and the noise. I am too, but I have to do it in order to actually be able to play the game and win. Linhart's already complete, thanks to me having him in the team in the other story.
Hey, anything that makes me stronger. Can't let this power go. Can't let this power. Hey, anything that makes me stronger.
And I don't have enough for anything else. All right.
Don't neglect your daily studies.
Let's go to the strategist.
Which battlefield are you headed to?
Oh, Anna's on the map. Here we go. After this level is where we'll call it. Let's see what we're up against here. Axe fighters, gauntlets, sword fighters. That's it. So we need someone to deal with the sword fighters. We have Shez for that. She can also deal with axe fighters as well, so that's good. Now we need someone to deal with the... Is it brawlers? I believe it was brawlers, right? Yeah, it was brawlers. So we need someone to deal with them, too. And brawlers are usually weak to bow and arrow users, and I don't think I have a bow and arrow user at the time. So I'll have to give a bow advantage to somebody. Swap out
this war is ours to be won.
Those two. And now let me real quick go down to him. And we will give him advantage over brawlers. There we go. Now he doesn't have a weakness at all. And we'll need to swap out him as well.
You don't expect me to go out there and fight, do you?
Yes, I do. Stop being a baby.
Let's earn our keep. Run away as fast as you can!
Though the wind blows, victory is never the
other. There you go. Save these guys. Let's go across here to help these guys now. Last one over here. Enemy. Ah, I'm frozen. There we go. And that was probably one of the quickest levels I've ever done.
Uncover, Hubert.
It appears those who slither in the dark had nothing to do with any of this. This plot was hatched by Houses Regan and Gloucester alone.
In other words, we know exactly where the idea to encircle our troops came from. Claude von Regan, leader of the Alliance.
He's going to be a true thorn in our side now that he is in charge. Back when Duke Regan had no clear heir, the lords were busy maneuvering to be next in line, and Claude appeared in an instant and laid claim to the seat of power. We were hoping that would be enough to throw the Alliance into disarray. But he has done a remarkable job of seizing the reins.
Feigning discord with Gloucester while they privately schemed together was an especially nice touch. Sadly,
It seems we're facing a gifted tactician as well as a skilled leader.
Yet for a tactician, he woefully underestimated Count Burglis. I say we finish his education. It is time Claude learns the gulf between his power and the Empire's cannot be bridged with a few clever tricks.
Alright, we'll end it there. If you enjoyed the video, like and subscribe. I will see you guys next time.